This will be a quick video. Want to show you how I rough out the outside with the spindle gouge. This is walnut. And this will be with bull gouges. This is much larger blank, so I'll use tailstock. This is a long grind. To use spindle gouge to cut the tenon. So this block is, I'll measure it, 8 by 4.5. Nice deep bowl. Do this one as well. Similar size, maybe a bit deeper. Now I can use asymmetric grind as well. done as well. For a few minutes. Now this one has a bit still. So when I reversed it, I cut that off. And usually for these smaller ones, I use a spindle gouge. I usually don't wear gloves, but it's cold day and I was out with the chainsaw and if you remember the video Day in the Life of Me, behind the cherry logs I was cutting there was walnut logs. Fortunate I got that walnut log for free with the cherry I bought, but it was standing too long, something like almost year and a half in the field, and the sapwood almost it's like a sponge, so this is basically all of the heartwood, so all of the black stuff, brown stuff on the walnut. That's the only usable pieces I have. Now I don't use resin to stabilize stuff, I just like them natural. I'll show you how I core out this one. Just first I need to remove the pit that was up here. So the easiest way is to use the left wing and try to peel the side grain as much as you can. So you get big, long shavings, like this. This is asymmetric grind. Big shavings and thick as well. Okay, just want to make sure that I don't have any pit left, just maybe a tiny bit more. Okay, I have a knotting system. Now I bought this used from a guy that he bought it as well used, and that the first owner, original one, overheat the curved blades, and the straight one is that's only usable. And but I will order myself curved ones for probably for the next winter roughing out process, on especially on bowls like this big. I use a turret, this device here. For me, this McNaughton is most versatile coring system. Now you have a one-way woodcut, they all work excellent, but I like the freedom of this one. Okay, let's core it out. So that's the straight one. And like I said, on next winter roughing out process that I usually do, I'll buy a curved blades. And this is actually, I believe, mini set, really thin one, but I want a little bit more thicker one, heavier. And some of these smaller ones, or shallower, not so deep, I just hollow out. And for hollowing, I think the asymmetric grind is just superior, or from the bottom of the flute to the right, that kind of profile. So I just removed the little crack that was here. So I want to go to the center, again peeling cut. Always take off the sharp edge. That's for the drying process, and so you don't cut yourself. Thank you. may soften this edge, and that's it. So this walnut is kind of different in color because, like I said, it start to rot, decay. So should be interesting color in it. I'll show you the hollowing of the small one as well.